on coastline.
Just okay, or
their team is okay on coastline. I mean, we could guess indeed. It's gonna be either Echo or Maestro normally.
And he's also actually out of support. Now Kabouter takes down Quadzi in a 1v1, meaning the Valkyrie is off the board.
Aquarii downstairs in the bar. It's gonna be HG Dev to pick up the next frag right there. Leonsky to get the instant frag. Takes down Kabouter as well. Now has to take down Kento to stay alive, but that won't be the case. Kento comes up the stairs right there. We'll be taking him down, and that means the first round will be going up to Osleos.
Meaning we're back to a 4-on-2 once again in favor of Osleos, as they are still approaching. Avajo now takes down Krax in 3v2. Still two pro players alive on Osleos. And will they get those kills? It seems like HG Dev will fall. And only Conti, Rocketti and Snebben are surviving, but not for long. Kanto will be taken away, and Avaj with a huge round. Was that a 4k or an ace?
Leonsky
had one.
He at least had three right there, so I think it's a potential 4k, but
it's
he knew
classical. Exactly. I have a hole in the wall and I will destroy you with it. Kanto, though, actually chokes onto Quadzi.
Three fires won't be able to get him down. He's going to get hunted down by drones. Once he got prone, but it's going to be Slemon with the trade. Well, completely unscaped right there, so he just didn't get peeked anytime. Has to watch out that he's actually going to get pushed from the other side. Goes aggressive, picks up one right there, spots out the second. We'll get that as well! Avajo with the double kill. Now Leonsky trying to shoot some feet through. So Avajo is going to have the opportunity to possibly heal himself back up. It's going to be Leonsky to take down Slebin. Instant refrag potential coming in right there, but no. Refrag isn't there yet. Gruxen is going to die as well. That's two rounds in a row for Trust Gaming, as they once again turn around a 2-on-X situation.
Actually,
and managed to win
four
it
twice.
Yeah. So
how flexible can one man be? Does he do yoga?
Oh, he's going to get taken out early right there by Slebin. Knew exactly that potentially player could have been in there. Fudge with a lack of knowledge right there. Kanto, look at him wait until the very perfect moment to take down D-back. HG Dev, in the meantime, just going down for the plant. Kraxen and picking up one more as well. Mies is going to be dropping right next to Kanto. Be picking him up as well. Quadzi for the refrag wants to go even more aggressive right here, but there's one player still behind him that he has to take care of, and he won't be doing that. It's going to be round number two, as we had a planned situation as well. Didn't really seem to be the matter. Just punch holes right there. Mies chokes onto Kanto. Kanto picks him up and punishes him for it.
Outside if he wanted to, yet he is waiting, and meanwhile Kanto will die to Avash. This is the third 2v4.
Quadzi is pretty dug in right there. Grenade is going to get cooked right there, and Quadzi is aware of that. Won't be picking up that frag, and it actually manages, no, doesn't manage to survive. And it turns it into a one-on-one situation. Lead in this matchup right here, but it's going to be Kraxen to come out on top and bring that round home to Osleos.
If Avash would have played it a little
bit. Side is going to be Leo. Kanto just being so aggressive right there, getting picked up by Leonsky.
Levin is a man now on the prowl, and he will find a player soon enough. It's Avaj going down, meaning it's back to a 4-on-4, and Quadzi, long angle onto Leonsky, takes him down as well. Now Slevin will fall. Meets actually with a double. The Gregson comes in for the 2-on-2 situation. Quadzi still low, still with a C4, waiting for his moment to strike.
Going in right there. Gregson now going aggressive, pulls out ahead. Giz going to get killed by D-back, and that's going to be Trust Gaming to get the defuse done by the hands of D-back, as they will be drawing things up 3-3. Still not.
That would be the classic Benlux mistake of not droning correctly, and so Quadzi will fall to Kanto Rocketti, using the first player due to it as well.
The perfect example right there, Kabouter using his signature move right there, but D-back will actually get the better hand out of him, getting that frag unscathed. Kanto is now taking over the spot right there. We see the phone going off, and not sure still. Feels like 12 seconds, 15 seconds maybe. Actually, triple kill from Kanto as we were trying to figure out how long it took. Just spraying them all down right there. Now going up for his fifth one as well. That would be an ace, but no, it's going to be HG Def to get that one in. But the impact nade right there, and everybody just lining up at that point. Now Kanto to get a 4k in total.
Kanto in the meantime above on that window will be opening that up. Get a clean headshot, but actually missing it first.
Well, is going to be getting a vertical angle right now. It's going to be Kraxen to take down Meads. Kanto should be aware of the fact that D-back is the last man standing. Slebin goes aggressive, and will he pick up the frag? No, D-back survives, but he's eventually going down. It's going to be Kanto to finish him off, and that means Osleos take up the next round as well. There's going to be two consecutive ones in a row. Right now, score is going to be 5.
He's close to the side as well, so that doesn't really bother him that much, as now Kraxen will be shot in his back by D-back.
Not for at all, as Kanto and Slebin are both playing right there.
Kinto picks up a fudge from the vertical angle. And indeed, Meats now will be going for the plant. Hatch is going to get opened up. And that will mean Slebin will fall to the hands of Deepak. Leonsky gets Kapowder as well. And it's going to be all up to Kinto. This 1-on-3 situation with only 30 seconds left on the clock will be running straight into the pre-fire of Meats. That means 4-5 is going to be the current scoreline. However, Hookah Billiards will be unlocked again.
He's now moving into the staircase. Drone is also working out. A big pre-fire from Avash. And a big kill onto Slebin as well. Problem is, Counter Raketti brings it back onto Quasi.
It's not really advisable to put in your Heart Destructor like this, but he will get the kill to Kinto just to put it on his player resume.
The other side of the bomb site, Leonsky is just holding the angle, waiting for HG Dev to peek, so he will. Actually, a good trade kill from him, but the problem is, it's now Kabouter in 1v3.
He's now trying to fight back, trying to turn this one around. Has a little bit more HP to work with, but it won't be enough. It's going to be Leonsky to draw things up. And we are 5-5 right now, still in anyone's game. And with two more rounds left, we are definitely going to
deal some damage and maybe get a kill later on. But here we see Kinto taking a hatchet onto Avash. Against Pro League players, he knows how to step up.
Oh, yeah, he definitely does. Kraxen now is going to get receive some flashbangs. Actually, vertical play, perfectly played right there. Meats taking them out. And that leaves it all up to HG Dev, who is going to get taken down by Quads. He's going to be Trust Gaming, the first team to reach 6 points, have that 1 point in the bag, and right now they turned around the pressure up to Osleos.
ADS, Kinto Raketti wants to go on the aggression, will actually do so, but doesn't look far enough left, as there was a player standing by, I believe it's actually Avash, who is now going for the return frag, but it's actually Leonsky being taken down by Kinto. He went low though, but can heal himself up and now will walk into the aim of another Trust Gaming player as he was baited out by the drone.
Perfectly team play right there. Just as he was healing himself back up, he was droned out, got taken out as well.
So I don't know if he got a memo how to work bets as Kraxen will now go down. He won't really do too much with that because he's now in a 1v4. Slebin just dies to Quadzi and so he will be pushed in. Meets with another double kill. I'm just going to say, for a slow playing guy, usually he's doing mighty fine work. Even the XD coming out from Kinto.
Don't kick me your next time.
Oof. Just putting in the flame a little bit. And Effie, please enlighten us because, well, the hearts are still behind you. The heart is still beating in you whilst Osleos has just lost.
Well, what went wrong is we didn't spawn peak enough. Simple as.
That's actually a good one.
Oh, was that your. But. Looking at Trust Gaming, they were actually countering off these spawn peaks. They were just aware of the fact that you guys were spawn peaking at some point and just shooting at just pre-firing the windows.
I mean, you counter spawn peak then. You spawn peak even more and they get scared.
Did you actually pick Ghostline because you want to spawn peak more with this lineup? Because Ghostline has more possibilities for that?
No. I'll let you in a secret. We don't scrim.
Oh!
That's
what
I thought as well.
Really?
More
but
of a mix.
Effie, you have a strat book for
surprised?
This one as well, right? Just show it to us.
I haven't brought my strats today, but I decided to bring a little bit of this, right? So
okay.
You've got a profile on Kraxen.
Yeah.
His role is washed IGL.
Yeah.
A little bit more to the left now.
Role's washed IGL. And then you got his trait. So you got lazy.
Uh-huh.
Angry?
Yes.
Rubs people for a living.
Okay.
Physiotherapist. And likes to party.
Yeah, that's actually true from what I've heard and
like
seen.
Sounds like Kraxen indeed.
I also love the pictures there.
Yeah, it was a super
good
pictures.
Oh yeah, you got a couple good pictures. And then you got how to improve. So the way Kraxen improves is actually playing the game.
Yeah, okay, seems Kraxen logical.
What does he do?
You've got his previous achievements. Previous achievements being dropped by Trust Gaming.
Toxic coach, by the way.
All right.
I've got one more. Player profile, Kinto Raketti.
Yes.
Yes.
So, yep, you've got literally the best player in the world.
Uh-huh.
Looks like you can steal your lunch money.
Okay.
And then we still can't win with him.
Yeah, that seems
to be
about
true.
Right. Breaks my
and
heart.
And how to improve. You, Ashas, not me. And yeah, you've got his previous achievements. Pro League winner, Paris Major winner, Invitational's MVP. Winner, MVP of Season 9, I guess. Highest KD.
I guess.
And still can't win. with us.
No, so it's either you're coaching or it's Gregson not playing the game enough.
Which one do you think it is?
Or is it is Benelux harder than Pro League?
I'm going to go for the last one. It seems like the most logical one. Effie, once again, thank you for your great victory. This time I won't congratulate you with this. You've been a dear once again. Thank you very much. We love you, and we love your pretty face.